21474836647. This is not a random number. This is 2 to the power 31 minus 1, which is a prime number discovered by Leonhard Euler back in 1772. At that time, it was the largest prime number ever discovered. But why is this a special number? And what problems was it about to cause in today's world? 21474836647 is the maximum positive value for a 32-bit signed binary integer in computing. That was too much information in a tiny sentence, so let me explain. 32-bit computers store data in a sequence of 32 binary numbers. That's 32 numbers where each number could be either 0 or 1. A signed number means that it could be either positive or negative, thus they are preceded with a sign. So here's how you represent the number 0 in 32 bits. And here's how you represent +21474836647. The first 0 means that this is a positive number. So this is the maximum signed number that you can represent in a 32-bit computer. On those 32-bit computers, a signed number can go from -21474836648 to +21474836647. Now, 21474836647 seems like a huge number. It's well over 2 billion. But why is it a problem? Is it because some crazy rich guy cannot represent how much money he's got using a 32-bit integer? No. The problem is that computers represent the current date and time by counting the number of seconds since January 1, 1970 UTC. And that number used to be stored in a 32-bit signed number. We call the number of seconds since 1970 the Unix timestamp. At the time of recording, the current timestamp is 15075682445, which is shown in binary here. Now let's fast forward to Tuesday, January 19, 2038, 03:14:07 UTC. At this precise second, the number that stores the time will reach its maximum value of 21474836647. What do you think will happen when the number is maxed out? Are servers going to be damaged? Of course not, it's simply going to reset. We will go from +21474836647 to -21474836648, which will take us back to December 13, 1901. Not literally, that would be awesome though. Only the time calculated will be wrong. And that would cause a lot of issues with payments, smart cities, and pretty much anything that's running on a computer. This is what's known as the year 2038 problem. Thankfully, this is not a problem anymore, as most computers have moved or will have moved to 64-bit by the time it's 2038. But wait, wouldn't 64-bit just delay the problem a few more years? Well, on 64-bit computers, the maximum value for a signed number is by far greater than 21474836647. To be precise, it is 9,223,372,036,854,775,807. This will allow us to expand the time representable by approximately 293 billion years, which was way after the sun would have become a supernova and destroyed the Earth. That's reassuring. So using 64-bit computers solves the year 2038 problem. I just hope we won't have any 32-bit computers still hanging by then. That's very likely since most of the ATMs at the moment are still running Windows XP. If you want to know more about this special number, make sure to check out the references in the description below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe to my channel by hitting the subscribe button here. Also, I'd love to know what you want me to cover in future videos, so leave a comment and let me know. Ciao!